joining us on Grand Sumo Highlights. It's the opening day of the May tournament at the Ryogoku Kokuikan in Tokyo. Yokozuna Kisenosato is the center of attention, gunning for his third consecutive title. If he succeeds, it'll be the first time in 80 years for Rikichi to clinch three championships in a row from his first one. But the Yokozuna is still ailing from an injury in his upper left arm. Tickets for all 15 days of this tourney have been sold out, and lots of families have packed the stadium on Mother's Day. We kick off the top division bouts with these two facing off for the very first time. Yutakayama is a Shinryu Maku, or rookie to the top Makunouchi division. He's a typical pusher thruster. Kaisei from Brazil likes to work by getting a firm grip on the mawashi or belt. The rookie hits from a low angle and pushes from the left and snatches a left hand outside grip. Kaisei attempts a throw but is too high and is sent out. Yutakayama finds his first win in the top division from opening day. Yutakayama hits low and strikes the neck from the right and keeps his left hand outside grip. Kaisei tries a beltless arm throw, but that's prevented by Yutakayama, who pushes from the armpits for the victory. Yutakayama wins by yorikiri frontal force out. How did you feel fighting in the Makunouchi division? I was amazed. It was a great view. I want to continue with my pushing maneuvers and take it one day at a time. Congratulations. Thank you. Next, it's Onosho versus Daishomaru. These two are fighting for the first time in the top division, but they've met four times down in the second highest Juryo division. Onosho is another Makunouchi rookie, only 20 years old. Daishomaru is desperate to deliver his brand of sumo for his first kachikoshi or winning record in a year. Daishomaru clashes head first and drives, deflects the rookie's attacks and gets his right hand inside grip. Onosho charges forward, but Daishomaru circles around and puts him down. Daishomaru wins and goes to 1-0. Daishomaru keeps his head low and goes inside Onosho. He deflects the rookie's moves and gets that right hand inside grip. He tries to take control but backpedals because of Onosho charging in, but he wins by a thrust down. We now go to Tokushoryu facing off with Ishiura. It's a plus 60 kilo weight difference for these rikishi meeting for the very first time. Tokushoryu managed to produce more wins than losses in March when he was ranked at the very bottom of the top division. And Ishiura luckily maintained his rank despite a losing 7-8 record last basho. Ishiura goes inside Tokushoryu. Tokushoryu tries to get a hold of him, but Ishiura sticks to him, and that's all she wrote. Ishiura is the victor and advances to 1-0. Ishiura nosedives, goes inside. Tokushoryu tries to get a hold of him but can't. Ishiura continues to go and wins by oshidashi. Next we have Arawashi and Ura up on the dohyo. These men are locking horns for the very first time. Arawashi suffered back-to-back tournaments with a makekoshi losing record from January. Ura found his eighth victory for a kachikoshi winning record in his debut top division tournament in March. Ura keeps his head low and snuggles inside, gets both hands striking the armpits in a good position, and displays speed and technique. Ura outpowers the Mongolian for his first win in May. Ura dives under Arawashi. He brings his foe close to him and sticks to him and creates that stance for him to push him up from both armpits and gets victory by Oshidashi frontal pushout. We now have Shohozan and Takakesho. It's a battle of the pusher thrusters going against each other for the first time. A right hand slap by Shohozan. Another slap and another. But Takakesho continues to charge in, deflects the thrust, and now pushes Shohozan out. Takakesho takes the match and goes to 1-0. Shohozan initiates with a slap from the right. They clash and they go back and forth. Takakesho doesn't back down, deflects his thrust to the right and breaks his balance for the push-out victory. We next have Hokuto Fuji going against Ikioi. It's a first time meeting between these two. Ikioi had only 5 victories but sent Yokozuna Hakuho to the deck on day 4 in March. Hokuto Fuji suffered his very first makekoshi last basho since making his professional debut. Ikioi steps into his opponent and fires a right hand inside grip. Hokuto Fuji counters with a neck thrust, but Ikioi holds his ground and advances to push him out. Ikioi shows his superiority over his foe and kicks off day one in a positive note. Ikioi slides his feet and gets inside Hokuto Fuji for his preferred grip. Hokuto Fuji attacks with his neck thrust from the right, but Ikioi continues forward, and at the end, his armpit attack from the left turns out to be effective. We now have Takekaze versus Shodai. Veteran Takekaze is facing Shodai for the 5th time. He's lost all of the past 3 bouts by a pushout. Takekaze suffered 10 losses in March. He's recuperating after undergoing surgery on his right elbow. Shodai plunged down the rankings with a disastrous 4-11 outing last basho. Takekaze goes head first, rotates to the left, turning 180, and Shodai sends the veteran out. Shodai out-muscling his foe for win number one. From a bird's eye angle, Takekaze starts off low but moves to the left right after, but Shodai is right in front of him. Very good observation by Shodai. And has Takekaze right in front for the push-out win. It's Tochiozan locking horns with Takanoiwa. Tochiozan has a 2-1 lead in their matchup. Takanoiwa got his first win over his opponent back in September. Tochiozan produced double digits in March and strives to polish his initial charge to make his way back up the rankings. Takanoiwa ended up with 6 wins in his highest personal rank last tourney. Takanoiwa reaches in for a left-hand frontal grip, but Tochozan shakes that off, drives with his double-hand inside grip. Takanoiwa goes for a throw, an inside leg trip, but it's too high, and out he goes. The poised Tochi Ozan shows his experience and takes the heated bout to advance to 1-0. Takanoiwa slides his left hand for a maimitsu or frontal grip and moves forward, but Tochi Ozan gets both hands inside, shakes his hip, and gets rid of the Mongolian's grip. Takanoiwa is raised high but attempts an arm lock throw, then an inside leg trip from the left, but Tochi Ozan keeps his hips low for the win, wins by yorikiri frontal force out. We now have Daiesho versus Takayasu. These men first locked horns in the May tournament last year. Takayasu forced out Daiesho that time. Takayasu is gunning for a promotion to the second highest rank of Ozeki for the second time. Daiesho was boosted up the Banzuke, or official listing of ranks, to his highest career personal rank after a superb 11-win, 4-loss performance. Takayasu strikes into Daiesho's neck with ferocity, gets him high, observes him well, and slaps him down. Takayasu looking at his opponent really well and starts off an important tourney with a victory. Takayasu shoves back Daiesho by a sharp nodowa, or neck thrust, and gets his center of gravity high. Daiesho seeks to get inside, but Takayasu opens up to the right and sends him down into the clay. Powerful elbow blast by Takayasu, gunning for an Ozeki promotion. Daiesho dives inside, and Takayasu sends him onto all fours. We now have Tamawashi locking horns with Chiyo Shoma. It's a bout between two Mongolians. Veteran Tamawashi thrusted down Chiyo Shoma when they first met last September. Both go head-on, Tamawashi shoving his foe back and sticks to him, and Chiyo Shoma has no answer. Tamawashi, with authority, outpowering his Mongolian opponent for his first victory. Tamawashi clashes head-to-head and puts Chiyo Shoma away with one powerful push. Chiyo Shoma escapes to the left, but Tamawashi stays right in front of him, takes him to the edge halfway around the dohyo for the win. It's Okinomi facing off with Ozeki Goedo. Both men entered professional sumo in January 2005. Goedo leads the rivalry 16-5. Goedo enters this basho in Kadoban status, which requires him to produce at least 8 wins to stay as an Ozeki next tourney. Okinomi racked up double digits last tournament. Goedo drives in and snatches a left-hand inside grip. Both men not having their preferred grip. The Ozeki now tries to stick his right hand inside too, but it's moved back. He circles to the left and flings Okinomi down. Goedo taken back to the edge, but finds his first win in May. Goedo steps inside and reaches for the maashi with his left hand deep. He attempts to slide his right hand inside to right after. There you go. Trying to get his right hand inside. but Okinomi counters with a shoving attack from the left. Goedo backpedals, but uses his footwork to pull and pummel him down. We now have Teruno Fuji, another Ozeki, going against Endo. The two are fighting for the sixth time, and Endo has a 3-2 edge over the Ozeki. Teruno Fuji was the runner-up of the March tournament, missing his opportunity to clinch his second title. Endo marked his eighth victory on day 15 in March, his first winning record in half a year. The Ozeki with a powerful elbow blast, but Endo doesn't back off, finds a double hand inside grip. Teruno Fuji swings his foe for a throw, but Endo keeps his hips low for the force out. Endo upsets the Ozeki with technique and starts off with 1-0. Endo goes head-on into the giant despite his elbow blast, gets both hands inside. Teruno Fuji seeks to use an armbar and swings Endo around for an armlock throw, but fails. Endo keeps his hips low, and that allows him to get the Ozeki over the straw bales. We now have Chiyonokuni challenging Yokozuna Hakuho for the very first time. Newlywed, Chiyonokuni made his highest career personal rank this tournament as the top Maegashira rank and filer. Hakuho was sidelined for most of the March Basho. He's gunning for his 38th title, his first since the May tournament last year. A roundhouse slap by Hakuho goes in for the kill, but plunges down. But the referee's fan is directed towards Hakuho. A little scare there at the edge, but Hakuho manages to find his first victory in his 59th basho, reigning at sumo's highest rank of Yokozuna. Hakuho slaps Chiyonokuni from the left, goes inside with his right hand, immediately grabs that left hand outside. He doesn't give any time whatsoever to his first-time opponent and continues to march forward for the Yorikiri frontal force-out victory. It's Yokozuna Haruma Fuji versus Sekiwake Kotoshogiku. These 33-year-old rivals are facing off for the 60th time, with Kotoshogiku leading 32-27. Kotoshogiku was one win short of producing 10 wins in March and failed to get back the second highest rank of Ozeki. Haruma Fuji is not in his best condition after aggravating his left knee and right elbow. Haruma Fuji slaps from the left, gets that left hand inside, buries his right hand inside too, and escorts Kotoshogiku out. Kotoshogiku unable to do his brand of sumo on his 1,200th career appearance, and Haruma Fuji delivers his signature speedy sumo for his first win this basho. Haruma Fuji initiates his attack from the left, doesn't give Kotoshogiku any time to think, and now finds a double hand inside grip. Kotoshogiku strives to get something going from the outside, but is just too high. Haruma Fuji wins by Yorikiri frontal force out. It's Mitake Umi challenging Yokozuna Kakuryu. These two locked horns on opening day last basho. Kakuryu has a slight advantage, taking three of their four encounters, but Mitake Umi put dirt on the Yokozuna in January. Kakuryu is looking to grab the Emperor's Cup for the fourth time. Mitake Umi marked his first winning record in his highest personal rank of Komusubi in March. Kakuryu, taking the driver's seat from the initial charge, moves Mitake Umi back, but pulls! Mitake Umi recovers and bulldozes him out. Mitake Umi using his footwork well and sticks to the Yokozuna to go 1-0. Kakuryu takes the better of the tachi-ai, or initial charge, stepping into his foe, continues his thrust, and takes Mitakeumi to the straw bales. But the Yokozuna suddenly pulls, and that gives Mitakeumi time to regroup and charge forward. Mitakeumi also stays low from the initial charge. He gets that opportunity when Kakuryu pulls and wins by Oshidashi frontal pushout. The final bout of opening day is between Yokozuna Kisenosato and Komusubi Yoshikaze. This is their 20th time locking horns, and the Yokozuna has an overwhelming 15-4 edge. Kisenosato has his eyes set on clinching his third consecutive title after a historical come-from-behind championship in March, despite injuring his upper left arm. It's the first time in 9 tourneys for Yoshikaze to return to the 4th highest rank of Komusubi. Yoshikaze dives into the Yokozuna and pushes from the right and gets a double hand inside grip. Kisenosato is shoved back and is too high. Attempts a desperate arm lock throw, but no good. Kisenosato losing from day one. And Yoshikaze starts off the May tourney with a huge upset over the injured Yokozuna. Kisenosato aims to get a left-hand inside grip, but is prevented by Yoshikaze's push from the side. Yoshikaze gets both hands inside, takes control. Kisenosato is just standing straight up, tries to hurl his opponent at the edge, but fails. Yoshikaze wins by Oshidashi. And that's all for this broadcast of Grand Sumo Highlights. We hope you enjoyed opening day action of the May tournament here in Tokyo. Quite a few upsets from day one, with Yokozuna Kisenosato, Kakuryu, and Ozeki Terunofuji biting the dust. Thanks for watching, and please join us again for more Doskoi action to come on day two. Well, wherever you are, do take care, and gokienyo.